cat, you can out lick my balls, your deck sucks. And where have you been?
Picking up new sponsors, buying cards I need to finish decks, and getting a football signed by former Dallas Cowboys wide receiver Dez Bryant.
Well, that was a good answer.
Sure was, so what's up with the attitude now? I haven't even been here.
Him.
Hola.
Yeah, why couldn't we get a dog or something? Fluffle dog, Marin. Any dog would be better than this one.
I embrace that. And own it.
You have no shame.
And you have no fans.
Coach Snap to... No fans, huh? Then how did I get a monopoly on larvae moths so I could make this? You know I could trap you in here, right?
I hope they spam mail you with Jerry Beans Man again.
Haha, they can't! The P.O. box is closed! Actually, they can now. I just opened up a new box.
Beans.
If you all would excuse me, I'm gonna go hide in my room. You guys suck.
You know, he is the biggest baby. That is correct, I have opened up a new P.O. box. I promised my fans a long time ago that I would be opening up a new box at some point, and that has been done. And oddly enough, my parents of all people really liked the fan mail and wanted to see that come back. So we're bringing it back, But first, before we go over the address, before we open up some stuff, to start off the new fan mail series and before I show off, you know, a lot of the old fan mail and everything that I plan on doing in this episode, I wanna talk about some things. First, I won't be showing everything on camera because I don't want to get completely overwhelmed like last time, and I don't want to bog down the channel with just mail videos, so I'm pretty much only going to be showing off the highlights, but in their own episodes. That is correct, episodes. So the cooler stuff I get, the more I have to go off of. But previously on fan mail, guys, I would charge the cameras overnight, wake up Monday morning, pick up the mail, come home, open the mail, get everything opened up and all that before the cameras died, and then rush to edit and upload sometimes almost 2 hours of raw footage, just, you know, in time for Fan Mail Mondays. And I'd rather not go through all that again. So we're gonna be doing kind of an episodic deal based on what is sent. I'm gonna be doing, you know, just like cool standalone videos instead of, you know, Fan Mail Monday every single Monday like before. Now about sending stuff, let's go over some rules. First off, I will be signing cards and sending them back. That is something I will be doing. Not in overabundance, please, for reasons stated just a second ago. If you do want cards signed and sent back to you, be sure to include your own packaging that you want your card shipped back in. I'm talking stamped, addressed, and all of that, because just like with the last fan mail series, this guarantees that everybody gets their stuff back because shipping has already been paid for and you wrote down your own address, so I know that it's getting back to the right place. Every now and then on fan mail back in the day, I would have to try to, you know, give cards back to people on camera because they would get returned to me. Let's not do that, guys. I want everybody to get their stuff back. I want to show off some cool stuff on camera, and I want everybody to have a good time. The other rule is, if you guys want to send me cards or other Yu-Gi-Oh! Items, but have those items shipped back to you, that can be arranged, but be sure to message me first, because I want to be in clear communication with you if I'm going to be handling your property. A good example of this would be a rare Yu-Gi-Oh! Card or something that you want shown off on camera, but you obviously don't want to give away. Be sure to message me first. That can be arranged. I can show off your cool stuff, but once again, I want to be in clear communication the entire time. I don't want anybody to lose their stuff. I don't want anything lost in translation communication. I want everybody to have a good time. The best ways to get a hold of me are through Facebook and Twitter. The links to those are down in the description of every single one of my videos. And something that's about to be in the description of every single one of my videos is the P.O. Box, which is P.O. Box 214 Owosso, Oklahoma 74055. Yep, with all of that out of the way, that is the P.O. Box, 214 Owosso, Oklahoma 74055. Once again though, guys, please follow the rules to make sure that everybody gets their Yu-Gi-Oh! Items back, and to also make sure that everybody has a good time showing off all of their cool Yu-Gi-Oh! Stuff. starting with these items that I got from Eric Hopkins. Eric actually sent me these in return. He didn't have to. He won my Shadal mat giveaway a little while back. I mailed him the mat. He actually ended up giving it to his friend, which is really cool. A huge part of the reason why I wanted to start this back up. I want, you know, just good Yu-Gi-Oh vibes like that. You know, he was a big influence on wanting to start this back up, and he sent me some cool stuff to open for you guys. I didn't tell him that I was opening these to start fan mail back up. I guess he's gonna find out. Let's go ahead and open these. These are packaged pretty well. He didn't write anything down on that piece of paper. But then again, he didn't know that fan mail was starting back up. He just sent me some freebies. Witch of the Black Forest, guys. I'm trying to get this open without damaging the cards. I think I just did. Let's see, yeah, I did. All right, a Witch of the Black Forest and a Black Luster Soldier. Thanks, bro. These are actually misprints if you look. The text is not there on these. Look at that. That's pretty insane. I actually don't know how common that is with Toon Chaos for the cards to be missing the text. I hope it's not too common. That's not a good time. But then again, you know, misprint cards can be valuable. I mean, I value them. Miscuts and misprints aren't anything new in Yu-Gi-Oh, guys. I'm actually most old Yu-Gi-Oh cards from a certain era, like, you know, the Pharaoh Servant era, you know, the Goat era, let's put it that way. A lot of them, like most of them, are miscut. The foils are miscut and stuff, you know. What makes them cooler? In my opinion. You know, I like miscuts and misprint cards. But this right here, guys, I know what this is. I'm not gonna lie. All right, yeah, he is a complete madman and decided to just give this to me. He goes, hey, you want this? And I was like, you don't want it? Like, sure, okay. So yeah, guys, an ultimate rare first edition Cyber Jar. It's a work of art. I don't even want to open this. Like, I don't want to take it out of this, you know, top loader, because it's just so great. I think I'm going to have to, though, for the camera. All right, I got this open. I will very carefully, he even, like, double-sleeved this. Wow. I will very, very, very carefully take this out to show you guys, because this is an absolutely beautiful card. Great condition. I mean, let's look at the back. Yeah, it's a pretty good shape. Like, wow, for a card this old. Duelist Pack Kaiba, ultimate rare. It's not the oldest card in Yu-Gi-Oh by any means, or the rarest card in Yu-Gi-Oh, but Cyber Jar is classic nonetheless. Very, very good card in GOAT format. Eric, thank you so much again. You are a madman. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and double sleeve this and put this right back in here. This is such a cool card. I can't believe this. I can't believe this. I'm not gonna lie, guys, that's probably gonna be the coolest part of this episode, is getting this Cyber Jar. However, there is something I want to show you. I have actually kept every piece of fan mail that you guys ever sent to me. Call me sentimental, call me a pack rat, call me whatever you want, but whatever you call me, whatever you want to call me, here it is nonetheless. Toon World, the Millennium Eye, kept safe, of course. Can't let that get away. All my Yu-Gi-Oh magazines, all these random cards that I was sent, like, I didn't know what to do with them. I didn't want to throw them away, so I just, you know, magic cards and stuff. Yugi Nono, the penis leaking kaiju would normal summon add one Raigeki to your hand. Freaking broken, all these stupid fan cards. I actually have a deck box up there with just fan cards. This is actually a blank, a tent from the last UDS. I got that from a really cool judge, actually a judge that you guys have seen on video before. Some cool Yu-Gi-Oh magazines. I will be doing videos over these, before too long. I'll be going over all those, you know, eventually. I've already done a video on this one that you guys have seen. But, yeah, just every piece of fan mail, everything written on Whataburger wrappers or whatever. All these ridiculous memes. Like, I mean, guys, everything. I have kept all of it. Just, I mean, fan cards. Here's the fan cards I was talking about. And, like, and real cards. Look, there's real cards in here I have in here that, I mean, a lot of them are signed by fans and stuff. Like, anything signed by fans, I, of course, you know, kept. Like, there's tons of stuff in here, guys. You know, a lot of stuff, a lot of other cards and everything I have organized in boxes up there. But, yeah, I just wanted to show this off. I'm letting you know that, yeah, fan mail's back. And I had a lot of fun doing it last time. I missed it a lot. A lot of things have been happening, you know, with my life and in the world and all kinds of stuff that have kept me from opening it sooner, but the box is open now, guys. The box is open now, and I'm really excited to see what y'all send me.